greatest of all teachers and giver of love, hope, faith, and wisdom. Look upon your children, the teachers, learners, parents, guardians, and out-of-school youth and adults. We humbly ask for your mercy and forgiveness. Guide us to the right path. May our efforts be blessed with insights and understanding, wisdom and respect for all. Bless us with patience, for the path of learning is never easy. Bless our commitment to keep on learning new knowledge and experiences. Let your light shine upon us as we make our world a better place to live in. Amen.
DepEd Vision. We dream of Filipinos who passionately love their country and whose values and competencies enable them to realize their full potential and contribute meaningfully to building the nation. As a learner-centered public institution, the Department of Education continuously improves itself to better serve its stakeholders. DepEd Mission. To protect and promote the right of every Filipino to quality, equitable, culture-based, and complete basic education where students learn in a child-friendly, gender-sensitive, safe, and motivating environment. Teachers facilitate learning and constantly nurture every learner, administrators, and staff as stewards of the institution, ensure an enabling and supportive environment for effective learning to happen. Family, community, and other stakeholders are actively engaged and share responsibility for developing lifelong learners. DepEd core values, makajos, makatao, makakalikasan, at makabansa.
Mabuhay! Isang mapagpalang araw sa ating lahat. Ako ang inyong lingkod, Tutor Madge. Welcome sa ating ETUlay, ang ating libreng online tutorial na hatid ng ating kagawaran ng edukasyon, ICTS EdTech. Ang programang ito ay inaasahang makatutulong at maging karagdagang kaalaman sa mga mag-aaral mula kinder hanggang senior high school, ALS, ALIVE, at SPED learners. Bukod sa pagsagot ng mga modules, ang ETUlay ay may mga special programs din na siguradong aabangan ninyo araw-araw. Katuwang ang ating mga minamahal na mga magulang at guro ay maitutulay natin ang pagkatuto. Kaya, ihanda na ang inyong module, lapis, papel o kwaderno. Ihanda rin ang isip, mata at tenga sa isa na namang makabuluhang aralin. Tayo nang matuto kasama ang inyong volunteer online tutor sa oras na ito.
Yan, isang magandang Friday morning po sa inyo mga ka-techwiz. Kamusta po kayo? Today is Friday, February 25. It's the 36th anniversary of EDSA Revolution or the People Power One, no? Ayan, and happy viewing po sa ating mga loyal, no? Viewers na Katekwis. Ayan, si Enrico Dalupan. Ayan, good morning, Tutor A. I'm Enrico Manuel T. Dalupan, a grade 11 STEM from Budget Castillo High School. Ayan. And also we have Techquiz Marshall Bakay. Ayan, good morning po, tutors. Ayan. Ayan, also si Enrico ay nakatutok din, no, sa ating YouTube live. Ayan, thank you sa inyong hapatuloy, no, na pag-stream dito sa ating online tutorial, no? Ayan, so dumadami na. Sige, keep your comments coming. Ayan, good morning, Rodalyn Asherto and Maria Jadel Soriano Laom. Yan, good morning sa inyo. Thank you, mga ka-techquiz, ha? Ayan, so bagamat tayo ay holiday ngayon, pero syempre, ang karunungan at pagtuklas sa panibagong kalaman ay walang holiday po yan, okay? Tuloy ang pagkatuto, tuloy ang ETUlay online tutorial. Alright. So for today, we're going to talk about network media. So tayo ay nasa quarter 3 na, no? Second sem na po tayo sa senior high school. And tayo po ay nasa week 2 na po. Okay, so previously, last session, we talked about the fundamentals of networking kasi itong second sem natin, no, itong quarter 3, iikot tayo sa network, computer networks, no? So, importante na unti-unti na ma-bridge natin yung mga level of difficulties kasi hindi ganun kasimple ang mga topics, no, sa computer networks, no? Pero pilitin natin na maging light ang mga talakayan natin, no? Kaya nagsimula tayo sa yung mga basic or fundamentals of networking, no, yung mga commonly terminologies na available or na you can hear or maybe na nagagamit nyo on your daily day-to-day activities, no, yung mga LAN, yung Wi-Fi, no. So we discuss natin yung last week. All right? Sige, keep your comments kami, mga ka-techquiz. Okay, so muli ako po si Tutor A from Schools Division Office of Bataan, no? At lagi niyo pong matutunghayan every Friday, no? Kami po ang Senior High School ICT TVL, no? Every Friday po, no? Ang akin pong session is Computer System Servicing for Grade 11, 9 to 9:40 a.m. Ayan, good morning, Tutor Marlon Ramos. Good morning po, Tutor Lon. Alright? So, tuloy na po tayo. So, for today, nandun pa rin tayo sa learning outcomes, no? This is from the Computer System Servicing Curriculum Guide, no? Install network cables. At the end of our tutorial, you are expected to, one, identify the different types of network media and compare and contrast the primary types and uses of network media. So, kung last time we talk about the mga common terminologies, no, mga basic concepts sa networking. So this time, i-specify natin ano ba yung mga media, no, mga yun talagang sinasabi natin na kinakailangan, no, para makapag-network tayo, no. Kasi last time we talk about the network is a group of computers, no, connected to each other that enables them to communicate and share resources, no? No? And then those group of computers that we call networks, no, ay nakalink din sa ibang network. It could be on the similar topographical location or on a far remote area or intercontinental or interregion, no, connection, di ba? So ngayon, pag-uusapan natin, ano ba yung mga specific media or mga kagamitan that enables, no, those network of computers to be connected, no, to have a communication, no, of sharing resources, etc. Okay, so ayan yung pipilitin natin, no, na malaman o tuklasin ngayong session natin na yan. Okay? So I do hope na lahat ay nakahanda na makinig, no? Though siguro some of you ay maka experience ng problema sa internet connection, but it's okay, no? Pwede na niyo namang i-replay, no, ang ating session, okay? Sige. So let's start. So let's talk about network media, no? So it said that it is the actual path, no? Ibig sabihin, ito yung dinadalugan, ito yung hardware, no? Actual path eh, over which an electrical signal travels as it moves from one component to another. So meaning to say, ito daw yung nagtutulay, no? Ayan, tamang-tama, ETUlay, no? Ito daw yung nagtutulay, nagsisilbing tulay para magkaroon daw ng kung saan nagtra-travel yung mga electrical signals, no? Para magkaroon ng connection yung dalawang component, no? So yung component, ito yung mga device, let us say yung mga computers natin, yung mga network apparatus, etc. Alright? Yun. And then, in this lesson, we're going to describe the common types of network media. So ano ba yung tutor A? Ano ba yung mga typical or mga usual network media? Yan. So dito na natin pag-usapan yung mga twisted pair cable, no, yung coaxial cable, and then yung fiber optic cable, and then yung wireless technology. So ito kasi yung mga media na that enable us, no, na magkaroon ng network from one computer to another, or to another, from one network to another network. Ayan, ito yung mga media, mga talagang gamit na nagtutulay, no? Ayan. Yeah, let's proceed. So let's talk about first is the twisted pair cable, no? From the word twisted. Yan, nakikita niyo yan. So there's a, kung titingnan niyo, kala niyo apat na wires to, pero i-identify niyo mabuti, tignan niyo mabuti, no? As you can see, it's a group, no? Or a pair of twisted wires, no? So it's a type of cabling that is used for telephone communication and most modern Ethernet networks, no? So okay, by the way, okay, mali dito sa Ethernet saka internet. So internet working, ito yung sinatawag na nating information superhighway, no? But when we talk about Ethernet, ito yung Ethernet, it's a technology that enables computers to connect with each other. So it's a technology. Okay? So I do hope na malinaw sa atin yung pagkakaiba niya, no? So that is a twisted pair, no? So it's a pair of wires formed in a circuit that can transmit data, no? So when we talk about this mga network media, tandaan merong dalawang mahalagang function iyan na tinatawag, no? It's the data transmission and data receiver, no? It transmit and receives data, no? Okay, in the form of electrical signals, no? Okay, I do hope na clear tayo ron. Next, so this pair are twisted. So as you can see, tutor A, bakit ba sila twisted? Ayan. So para ma-prevent natin yung tinatawag na crosstalk, no? Bakit? Kasi kung naka-parallel lang silang mga lines na yan, and they both transmit and receive data signal simultaneously, so magkakaroon ng tinatawag nating noise generation na possibly magkaroon ng interruption sa network experience natin, no? Sa network or sa network communication. So kasi ang sabi nga, ang nag-flow sa mga wires na to, no, sa mga media na to, yung data in a form of electrical signals. So kaya yung mga engineers, no, they studied it, no, carefully, that na they have to do this, i-twist nila yung pairs, no? Ayan, as you can see, naka-twist yan, no? Para maiwasan yung tinatawag nating crosstalk. Okay? So, I do hope malinaw tayo ron. So, when an electrical current flows through a wire, it creates a small circular magnetic field kasi, no? So, ang purpose ng pagkaka tawag rito, pag-twist nito para maiwasan yon, no, yung noise na yon, no, yung tinatawag nating crosstalk. Okay? Yan. So, after the twisted pair, no, meron daw two types yan, no? Andyan si, shielded twisted pair. Yan. So, from the word shielded, as you can see, no, meron siyang as you can see here, I don't know kung nakikita yung mouse ko. Now, after this outer jacket, meron siyang overall shield after that. And then after that, meron pa siyang pair of shields, no, na nakabalot doon sa mga twisted pairs na wires. Okay? So ayan yung twisted pairs. Ayan naman may nakabilog. Alright? So STP, no, yung tinatawag STP o yung shielded twisted pair, it's a cable combined sa techniques of shielding, no? So, shielding, cancellation, and wire twisting. So, each pair of wires is wrapped in a metallic foil, no? Ayan, may foil yan. So, the four pairs of wires then are wrapped in an overall metallic braid or foil. Ayan. So, kaya siya tinawag na shielded, no? Alright? Next. So, the following summarizes the features of STP or shielded twisted pair. Okay? So, it has a speed of 10 to 100 megabits per second. No? And the average cost per node, moderately expensive. Kasi nga, shielded. So, it has additional protection and noise cancellation or cancellation coating. And then, media and connector size. Medium to large, and the maximum cable length is 100 meter. So, ang tinutukoy nating maximum cable length natin dito is yung once na nag-terminate ka, let us say, yung computer from your office, no? Then, i-wired cable mo yon 100 meter long, papunta doon, let us say, sa mismong tawag yung switch or let us say, router. No? Hanggang dun lang. Kasi pag humigit pa sa 100 meters, magkakaroon ka na ng tawag rito, ng network interruption. So, possible na magkaroon na ng pagkabagal. Kasi, tandaan, may mga data loss kasi yan mentre sumahaba, no, yung medium na tinadaanan ng electrical signals. No? Nagkakaroon ng ng loss din. No, that's why ang maximum niya na cable length 100. Kung higit pa sa 100 meters yung kakailanganin, kailangan na nating maglagay ng mga booster, no? It's a separate module din para ma-boost yung transmittal and receiving ng data, no, na dadaan dun sa ating cable. So I do hope malinaw tayo ron. Okay? So ay lang naman si STP or shielded twisted pair. Now, aside from shielded, meron din naman tayong tinatawag na unshielded twisted pair. So, UTP cable. So, kung si shielded twisted pair, commonly use ito sa mga corporate, especially sa mga data center, sa mga company talaga, no, that requires dedicated network infrastructure, no? Of course may mga standard kasi susundin niya, so commonly used dun yon yung STP. But dito sa commercial market, sa atin, let us say sa mga end user, ito yung klase ng twisted pair na madalas nating ginagamit, no, yung UTP or yung unshielded twisted pair. Alright? So, wala naman siya pinagkaiba sa shielded twisted pair, kundi wala lang siyang extra coating or shield protection. As you can see on the picture, no? After jacket niya, nandun na yung loob mismo ng twisted pairs. Okay? So, with that makes the UTP cable less expensive. Okay? But, its speed is about 10 to 1,000 megabits per seconds or Mbps. No? So, it's a less expensive, sabi ko nga kanina, kasi wala naman siyang mga shield protection, no? Like noong sa shielded pair, no? Then medium connector size niya is small, so UTP and STP cable are both using RJ45, no? Connector. So ito ano ba itsura ni RJ45? Ay wala pala rito, sorry. So, ipakita ko later. Sige. So, UTP cable, no, itong unshielded twisted pair, no, meron siyang at least 6 categories. And then, may mga subsequent categories kasi yung bawat category. Halimbawa, UTP cable, meron siyang tinatawag na category 1. Or yung pag pinapekli natin to, we call it CAT 1. No, C81, no? So, yung category 1 is used for telephone communications. No, so, these are not suitable for transmitting data, but for reception or receiving data lang. Kasi we all know telephone is an end-to-end voice call. No, so, that is category 1. Then, CAT 2, or yung tinatawag ng category 2, is capable of transmitting data at speeds of 4 megabits per seconds. Yan. So, 4 Mbps yung kaya ng category 2. While the category 3, no, is used 10 base T networks that can transmit data at speed of 10 Mbps or megabits per second. So, ayun naman tatandaan natin yung speeds na kaya niyang i-transmit. Alright? And of course, we have CAT 4 or category 4. So, it is used in the token ring networks that can transmit data at speeds of 16 Mbps. So, yung si CAT 1 up to category 4, these are the, let us say, yung mga kauna-unahang network medium na ginagamit. No? Pero ngayon, nowadays, dahil sa demand ng data, no, na kino-consume ng bawat isa sa atin, mapa-commercial use man yan or corporate use, no? That's why nag-upgrade sila into a much higher category. So may CAT 5 tayong tinatawag, si category 5 that can transmit data at a speed of up to 100 Mbps or megabits per seconds. No? And aside from category 5, meron pang susunod yung category 5E, no? CAT 5E. So, used in networks running at speeds of 1,000 megabits per seconds or 1 gigabits per seconds. Yan. So, ito na yung mga gigabits. No, ito na yung mga UTP types na makikita ninyong ginagamit sa mga corporate, no? Kasi it requires higher bits, so it's giga. After mega, we all know it's giga, no? And we also have, after category 5E, we have category 6. Okay, so typically category 6 cable consists of 4 pairs of 24 American wire gauge copper wire. So category 6, by the way, AWG is a very an abbreviation for American wire gauge. So makikita niyo yan kapag meron kayong mga cable, no? Halimbawa, ayan, meron mga imprinted anyan. May mga naka-print diyan kung anong type siya, AWG. Ibig sabihin ang ginagamit niya is yung American wire gauge standard, no? And then mapapansin nyo, as the number increases, no, tandaan, in using American wire gauge, ha, na standard, as the number, let us say itong 24, as the number increases, no, the wire becomes smaller or thinner, no? But in American wire gauge, as the number decreases, lumiliit, mas kumakapal, lumalaki naman yung wires, no? So tatandaan natin yan, ha. Then category 6 cable is currently the fastest standard for UTP. So aside kung si Cat5e is 1 gigabit per second, si category 6 kaya niya yung 10 gigabits per seconds na speed transmittal. Ayan. So that is UTP. Now, when we are going to compare si when we're going to compare UTP and STP, ito lang naman yung mga key points, no, para makapag-decide kayo, let us say, no, alin ba yung gagamitin. So the speed of both types of cable is usually satisfactory for local area distances. Kaya nga si UTP at I mean tong mga twisted pairs natin is commonly na makikita nyo, no, na nasa mga bahay-bahay na ginagamit sa mga schools o sa mga offices, no. Even in CSS, ito rin mga ginagamit natin, no. These are the less expensive media for data communication. So UTP is less expensive than STP. Bakit? Kasi nga unshielded siya, wala siyang added shield protection. Okay, ilang naman yung pinagkaiba nila, no, aside from major things. Alright? So, and then, because most buildings are already wired with UTP, no, many transmission standards are adapted to use it to avoid costly rewiring with an alternative cable type. Ayan, dahil nga cost-efficient yung presyo ni UTP, and ito daw yung most commonly used din, no, sa mga most buildings, no, that's why ito na rin yung ginagamit ng ibang mga service network provider, no, na cable. But still, it's depending on the specification and standards ng isang company, no. It varies pa rin. Okay? Pero syempre, cost-wise, alimbawa, cost-price-wise tayo, syempre, you're going to choose yung mas mababa. But that offers the same quality. Okay? Next, meron tayong tinatawag na coaxial cable. No, coaxial cable consists of a hollow outer cylindrical conductor, as you can see on the diagram, no? Ayan. Cylindrical siya, that surrounds a single inner wire made of two conducting elements. So dalawa lang yung conducting elements yan. Ito yung copper, yung nasa pinaka inner core, and then after niyan may plastic insulation. It's a kind of para styrofoam, no, styrofoam na insulation. And then after that, yung mga braided copper shielding naman. And then susunod doon yung outer jacket, no. So these elements located in the center of the cable is a copper conductor, sinabi ko kanina, and then insulator, and then yung braided copper naman. So it's a woven copper braid, no. So, the second layer or shield can help reduce the amount of outside interference. Covering the shield is the cable jacket. Yan. So, importante may mga coverings and insulation kasi we all know para mawala or maiwasan natin yung tinatawag nating interference. No? Yan. Kaya kailangan, yan yung purpose ng mga insulation and mga outer jacket. Okay? And also coaxial cable supports 10 to 100 Mbps and is relatively inexpensive. Mas mura kasi to. And then another idea, coaxial cable ay ginagamit din sa mga CCTV cameras installation, no, yung mga using yung tinatawag nating ano tawag rito, mga BNC, no, connector, no. Ayan, makikita niyan kung yung baka may mga CCTV kayo sa bahay, tingnan yung wires. And then sa end noon, mga BNC connector yun eh. Okay? So it ayan, dun madalas ginagamit ko coaxial cable. And then sa ano rin, sa antenna, ayan ng mga TV. Ayan. And then coaxial cable, it comes with different types din, no? Pero hindi naman na rin natin ano 'yon. I-discuss na rin naman, di-discuss pa. And also what ano yung isa pa sa magandang how to call this? A feature, no, ni coaxial cable with regards doon sa mga twisted pairs natin kay UTP and STP. Maganda rito even in the longer distance, so you can use it for, let us say, 500 meters, no, you can use si coaxial cable, no, without even interference, no. Ito yung maganda sa kanya, no. Pero syempre hindi naman to applicable sa mga computer networking, no, but sa nung dati kasi, especially yung mga token ring topology pa yung ginagamit, coaxial cable ang ginagamit to point out, to point or to connect yung mga routers, mga nodes, no, from point to point. Yun. Pero nowadays, mostly ginagamit na lang siya yun sa CCTV cameras, connection yun ng CCTV cameras papunta dun sa digital video recorder or kaya man sa antenna ng televisions. Okay. Then we also have here the plenum cable, no? Plenum cable is a cable that runs in plenum spaces, no, of a building. Okay? So pakita natin yung plenum cable, no? So meron tayong tinatawag na plenum airspace. As you can see, ito yung ating ceiling, let us say ceiling sa bahay or sa company, sa building. And then merong blocks, merong malaking space pa dyan. No, kumpaga sa bahay, parang tinatawag nating attic. Pero in network technology, tinatawag natin itong plenum airspace. No? Anong purpose yan? For proper ventilation, kaya ibang company nakita nyo may mga parang exhaust fan dyan. Okay, tapos, para kapag ka nagke-cabling tayo, no, dito natin tinatawag na nilalatag ng maayos yung mga cables natin. Okay? Kasi syempre, kailangan yung lugar, no, na paglalatagan natin ng mga network medium, no, na mga cable ay well space, no? Well, nagsi-circulate yung space kasi ang mga cable media natin, network media natin is made up of materials, no? It could be flammable pagka sobrang taas ng temperatura, no, sa kinalalagyan. That's why yung mga cables natin, ito yung mga plenum materials wherein it hindi ganun kataas yung flammability niya or na flammable siya, mababa, no, kapag plenum materials yung ginamit natin. Okay? So ito na may itsura na yung mga non-circulating airspace. You can see may close masyado, no? Napaka nipis ng air supply, no? So importante rin kasi yung ventilation na yon. Okay? Next. Yan. Next we're going to talk about the fiber optic cable. Yan. So hindi na bago si fiber optic, no? Matagal na to. I think late 2000s meron na nito. Existing na tong ating technology, no, sa fiber optic. So from the word itself, fiber, it's made up of hibla na ng cable, but no, as you can see, it's a glass fiber. It has a glass fiber and cladding. So it's dito. Excuse me. no? Nagraran yung data, no? But not in a form of electrical signal, but in a form of pulses of light. And we all know, no? Light is mabilis na medium yan sa pag-transmit. That's why napaka, kung yung connection nyo sa bahay, no, let us say naka-fiber na kayo, no, mas probably you will have a seamless, no, network experience, no. So that's what fiber optic cable offers, no. Ganun pa rin, meron siyang outer jacket, and then it has a Kevlar, no, reinforcing material. Pwede rin say Kevlar is a technology, no, for cushioning and protection. So ito ay style na para ano to, may it's kind of thin hair tawag rito, metal, no, kasi alam natin glass fiber ang nasa loob noon, so kailangan may extra cushion protection siya, kaya kahit mabend siya, no, doon lang sasabay yung nasa inner core na glass fiber, no, hindi siya masisira, mapuputol, no. Ayun ang purpose ng Kevlar reinforcing material, no. Okay, so I do hope clear tayo ron. Okay, and then we have the two types of fiber cable. So meron tayong single mode, and then meron tayong multi-mode. In single mode fiber cable, it allows only one mode or wavelength, no, of light to propagate through the fiber. So it is capable of higher bandwidth and greater distances than multi-mode, and it is often used for campus backbones. So this type of fiber uses lasers as the light generating method. So single mode cable is much more expensive than multi-mode. Its maximum cable length is more than 10 kilometers. So imagine 10 kilometers. And then we also have the multi-mode. A multi-mode fiber cable allows multiple modes of light to propagate through the fiber. It is often used for workgroup application and intra-building applications such as risers. It uses light-emitting diodes. So si single mode, laser ang ginagamit. Si multi-mode, LED, no? Mga light-emitting diodes as a light-generating device. Ang maximum cable length niya is 2 kilometers. Ayan. So ito yung mga common din na ito na yung mga cable na ginagamit ngayon na ng mga internet service provider. Si mga fiber na, kaya nga some of them ay na ISP ay i-re-require ka na mag-upgrade, no? Para kasi sa totoo lang ito na kasi yung ano, yung efficient, no, in terms of user experience, no, yung mga fiber optic, no, na cable. Sabi nga sa'yo na seamless ang ano niya, network connection. Okay? Then, in fiber optic, syempre, kung si network, si UTP or si twisted pair cable, no, gumagamit tayo ng RJ45, no, yung tawag dito, yung RJ45 yung ano natin, yung as our connector on the end, no? Sa mga fiber optic, there are two commonly, pero marami to, no, na use connector. So meron tayong si SC or si subscriber connector type, no? It's a feature of full push connection and disconnect, as you can see, and rather than si ST fiber optic connector, no, it's a kind of bayonet type connector. Ayan, round siya. So katulad ng mga BNC, no, na connector na ginagamit sa mga CCTV cable, no, sa mga RG6 or yung coaxial cable, no. Ayan yung mga commonly connector na makikita natin ginagamit when it comes to fiber optic cabling. Right? So in CSS, ang ginagamit kasi natin yung mga twisted pairs, no, na UTP or STP cable. Hindi pa tayo nagpa-fiber optic kasi it has a different qualification is TESDA, no? I think it's doon sa fiber optic broadband installation. So may ibang qualification yon. Okay? Alright, next. So, the following summarizes the features of fiber optic cables. Speed niya is more than 1 gigabytes per gigabit, sorry. It's more 1 gigabits per second. And average cost per node, syempre expensive, no? But anyway, ito na yung trend ngayon. So, kaya mo lahat ng ISP sumusunod na rito sa fiber optic. No, yung connector niya is small lang din naman, and then yung maximum cable length niya is more than 10 kilometers for single mode and up to 2 kilometers for multi-mode, no? Ayan. So I do hope malinaw tayo rito. Okay? So after that, we're going to talk about naman yung mga wireless communication. Okay? So when we say wireless, no? Hindi naman totaling wala ng wire, 'di ba? Wireless, nalelesen nila yung paggamit ng wire. Meaning to say, instead of yung laptop, i-connect mo sa router mo, Wi-Fi router mo through LAN cable, no? So, kung meron namang Wi-Fi or wireless fidelity capability yung net, yung ano mo, yung laptop, at the same time, router mo is Wi-Fi capable, so you are able to do this, what we call wireless communication, no? So si wireless communication, dahil nga siya ay wireless, so it uses what? Radio frequencies, yung frequencies, no? Sa paligid, no? Or infrared waves to transmit data between devices on a local area network, no? For wireless LAN area networks, so a key component is the wireless hub or access point used for signal distribution. So ipagpalagay natin, yung router nyo, no, ayan yung nagdi-distribute ng signal. So for wireless connectivity. So kailangan lang yung mga device nyo is wireless or Wi-Fi capable. Okay? So hindi na siya gumagamit ng wires, hindi na siya gumagamit ng UTP STP, hindi mo na kailangan ng coaxial cable. Of course, yung mismong router natin, syempre kailangan ng network media, no, let us say fiber optic cable, no, papunta dun sa service a box or yung tinatawag nating access port point ng mga ISP provider natin na nasa nakakagabit sa mga poste, no? So, yun, yung modem natin, yung access point natin ay yun nag-provide ng signal distribution. Then gumagamit tayo ng radio frequency. Ito yung mga hindi basta-basta nakikita in naked eye, so kailangan ito ay nasa spectrum ng wavelength, no? No? Ayan. Okay, so that's kailangan mo ng dedicated device that is capable of receiving and transmitting this kind of radio frequencies. Alright? Yan, so with that, let us summarize our topics for today. I do hope mga ka-tech quiz ay nakakasunod pa kayong lahat. Ayan. Alright? And so, coaxial cable consists of a hollow outer cylindrical conductor that surrounds a single inner wire conductor. Okay? So, mayroong inner core, tapos may insulator, and then may susunod na braided copper wire, and then outer jacket na. So, that's coaxial. UTP cable is a four-pair wire medium used in a variety of networks. No? Unshielded twisted pair, no? Si UTP. And STP, or the shielded twisted pair cable, combines the techniques of shielding, cancellation, and wire twisting. Okay? And fiber optic cable is a networking medium capable of conducting modulated light transmission. No? Pag single mode, it uses laser. Kung multi-mode, it uses LEDs, no, for light transmission. And also, wireless signals are electromagnetic waves that can travel through the vacuum of outer space and through a medium such as air, no? So hindi siya nakikita, but it has something to do with electromagnetic waves, no? It is not cannot be seen in our naked eye, no? Yan. All right, so with that, do you have any questions, mga katekwis? Ayan, sige, you can place your comments or your questions kung may hindi malinaw sa sa ating mga pinag-aralan. So you may do so. Putting your comments on the comment box. Yan. Kung wala na, of course, quiz time tayo. Okay, ready na ba? Sige, kapag ready na, you can put your answers in a comment. Okay na? Sige. For number one tayo. Ah, lumabas agad, sorry. Ayan, so what is the maximum speed? Maximum cable length of four shielded twisted pairs. So ayan, bigla na lumabas yung sagot, sorry. So it's letter C, no, 100 meters, no, ang maximum cable length for shielded twisted pair. Ayan, so sorry, parang nagkaroon ata ng problema sa ano ko, presentation. Anyway, sige. In number two, which connectors does UTP use? Sige, teka lang. I-ano ko to. Para... Direct? Mag-share ako ng ibang ano. Hello, direct? Epic fail po kasi ano ko direct. Yung isang screen ko na lang po direct. Sayang naman no, mawawala po kasi yung thrill eh. Yung isa na lang po direct eh. Teka lang, mag-stop screen sharing po ako. Share ko po yung Chrome tab ko direct ha. Pa ano na lang po. Ayan, direct, okay na po. Yung isang ano ko na lang direct. Hello, direct. Direk. Anyway, sige, hayaan na natin. Sige, dire-diretso na tayo. Bonus na lang yung mga question ngayon. Alright. And then for number three, wireless communication uses which of the following to transmit data between devices on a LAN? So, fiber optics ba? LED ba? Radio frequency? Or none of the above? Of course, wireless communication to. So, therefore, it uses radio frequencies as a medium for transmitting data. Okay, and four, a fiber optic cable is a network cable that contains strands of glass fiber inside an insulated casing. Of course, it's true, no? Which is protected by a Kevlar reinforcement wires. And next, last for number five, coaxial cable can run for a longer distance unboosted. No? Sabi ko kanina yung mga twisted pair kasi may mga maximum length ng sila. Let us say 100 meters. After that, kailangan mo na siyang gamitan ng mga booster module. No, rather than kay coaxial, no, it can run into, let us say, 500 meters. No, unboosted, na wala kang ginagamit na ibang module to boost the signal. No, so that is true. Alright, so I do hope na malinaw ang lahat, mga katekwis. Kung hindi, kindly put your comments, no, your thoughts in the comment box. All right. So with that, muli kami po ang Senior High School Information Communications Technology team, no, ng TBL. With me is si Tutor Pau, ang aming ang mentor at ang tutor for programming grade 11, and yours truly, Tutor A for CSS grade 11, and also Tutor Bell for programming grade 12, and for CSS Grade 12, andyan po si Tutor Lon. Ayan, muli ako po si Tutor A from SDO Bataan, and shout out po sa mga ka-techwiz natin. Yan, dyan po sa Bataan at sa iba't ibang bahagi ng Pilipinas. Alright, muli, thank you. Oh, wag po kayong bibitiw. Tutok lang, susunod na po si Tutor Lon para sa Computer System Servicing Grade 12. Muli, nasa pagbabahagi ang ating pag-iral. Diyos mabalos. Mag-ingat po ang lahat. Paalam!
Ang husay naman! Natapos mo ang iyong tutorial session kasama ang iyong mahusay na ETUlay Tutor. May bago ka bang natutuhan? I-share na yan gamit ang hashtag ETUlay Level Up. Huwag aalis ha, dahil may susunod pang programa na pwede mo ring panoorin at salihan, dahil naghihintay na ang iyong mga tutors. Happy learning dito sa ETUlay!